We begin in the Democratic Republic of Congo, where the military is having to protect Ebola health workers after attacks on treatment centres. The violence is defying efforts to curb the spread of the virus. This is the second worst Ebola outbreak on record. It's been centred on the North Kivu and Ituri provinces in the northeast of the country. So far, about 1,600 people in the two regions have been infected with the virus since mid-last year, and more than 1,000 people have died. Now, the presence of warring armed groups mixed with people's deep distrust of the government and outsiders is hampering the Ebola response.
A body on the ground, this the aftermath of another attack on an Ebola treatment centre. Security forces managed to fight off the attack. It was carried out by a Mai Mai rebel group, one of many operating in Congo's volatile northeast.
One of the guards came to tell us not to panic. The police had told him the centre was under attack.
The precarious security situation in this part of the country has complicated efforts to control the Ebola outbreak. The various rebel groups have been accused of spreading rumours about Ebola for their own political gain. This is adding to an environment of distrust towards health workers. Some villagers believe the disease was created to take their money.
False information sometimes spreads much quicker than correct information. But denying Ebola is very dangerous. As we often say, the people will die of ignorance. Therefore, we're trying to fight this ignorance in the population.
An effective vaccination program has halted the spread in some northeastern towns. But others, particularly prone to rebel groups, have seen a spike in new cases. The World Health Organization is now warning there's a risk infections could spread to other provinces. In a statement last week, it said, without commitment from all groups to cease these attacks, it is unlikely that this Ebola outbreak can remain successfully contained in North Kivu and Ituri provinces.